He did it because he
liked it. That's why.
Okay. We'll bring the January, why do I have January 26th? February 9th meeting of the St. Mary's County Board of Planning Commission. I'm going to say Board of Appeals, Planning Commission into effect.
It says February 9th. I didn't give you the wrong paper.
It's been that long of a day. We only have one item on our, agendas this evening, which is a Wildwood update. Is everybody, there's no additions or deletions to the agenda. I'd like to have a motion to accept the agenda as written.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Okay. We also had some minutes that were sent to us, the January 12th minutes. Did everybody have a chance to review those minutes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All in favor of the, that, of accepting those, say aye.
Aye.
Okay, at this time, I'll let the board members, starting at my left, introduce themselves if they would.
Patty Robrecht.
Martin Siebert.
Susan McNeil.
Shelby Guazzo.
Howard Thompson.
And Merrill Evans.
Also from Land Use and Growth Management, we have Mr. Bill Hunt and Mr. Bob Bowles here. Also from the Legal Department, we have George Sparling with us today. Sean Day and Tom Thomas are here with us from Wildwood. Let's do this.
All right,
Sean, are you the
All right, I'll be the MC tonight. Sean Day with Duval LLC and Gordon Thomas, Stanley Martin Homes. So, of course, this is our first update before you for Wildwood with respect to the PUD for 2015. So we'll get started with that. Of course, you have a handout there. We'll go through it as I talk about the tabs in there, and then we'll open it up for questions at the end. So the summary of information since our last update is on the first page there, the progress report. And for site plans approved, there's nothing new there to report. And then that brings us to the building permits, which we had 70 new ones since the last time. And then down below that is a listing of each development that a new building permit was received. And then, of course, the totals so far in each one of those categories. And then for certificates of occupancy, we had gotten 54. And again, the listing of development pods that received, let me actually go to the tab. There we go. There, I got it. So the listing is there indicating which ones received new unit approvals and then the totals. And then the last column on that page is the site plans in process. And we have the two sections of the Maryland Route 235 development, phase three and phase four. Next, we have the activity update. And the first chart tracks the total number of units allowed in the PUD against the units that are built. And we see the numbers there, units built at 2605. The PUD, and then the second chart, which is on the next page, breaks down the total number of units by C of O,
by unit type.
And we see there the listing for single family, the total there in the PUD, and then single family attached and detached, and then the condominium units to get to the 2605 number. And next is the sectional approval history. And then table one includes a charting of units by development pod within Wildwood. And the columns provide the unit totals for original approved units, recorded lots, building permits, and COs. And again, the very total number down there for COs is 2606. Sorry, 2605. Next one is the land use program. And the top three charts are a historical reference indicating how the blended density of just over four units was calculated and approved in 91. And these charts remain unchanged from PUD update to PUD update. While the bottom chart tracks the progress against the approved density, resulting in the 26005 number of units built. These 1,187 remaining. And the next is the map, which you had in the middle insert there. And that, of course, shows all the developments in Wildwood to date. And then the next map on the handout is just a blow up of that same map. And we have the open space developed, open space square footage schedule. And the top overall open space column tracks the amount of open space at 444.92 acres and the developed open space at 84.88 acres required to build out. And then the second two columns track the amount of required and provided open space for the current built units. And Wildwood is on pace with its open space requirements, as is evidenced by the excess provided of 317.85 acres of open space and 72.31 acres of developed open space. The next one is open space developed open space schedule. And the next approved development envelope summation and the Wildwood Village development envelope summation track the amount of open space and developed open space required and provided based on the number of approved units. And the chart breaks out the retirement village developed open space separately based on the 102 approved units there. And we can see that Wildwood is on pace with its open space and developed open space by approved development envelope summation with the excesses provided at 288.09 and 44.48. And then again, the retirement village has excess open space and developed open space at 17.79 and 25.55. So that's all for the presentation. Pretty much the typical data that we report for the PUD from time to time. So if there's any questions, we'll go through them at this time.
How's your stoplight working out at the end of the road?
Well, you're very happy with it.
Mm-hmm. I mean, have you heard anything, you know, it clogs anything up or everything's moving smoothly? Everything.
To be honest, I haven't heard a word about it.
Well, if it was bad, you'd hear about it.
If it was bad, I'd hear about it, mm-hmm. for sure. I think that it's created a easier access point for people that turn that direction. I know I drive up Route 4 every morning, commuting to our office, and it seems to work fine. Don't see any accidents. And like you said, typically I hear about things if they're a problem, and it's been very quiet, so...
How about your usage of the back road, Lawrence Hayden Road? Is it being used more? I mean, do you see more traffic going in and out of it now?
You know, I think the usage of it is about the same as last time. You know, there are definitely people that use it going in and out. I think the residents within Wildwood use it, you know, where it makes sense. It certainly provides relief when needed. But it doesn't seem to be overly used or underused.
Do you think they would use it a little bit more if they would finally turn that light on at St. John's Road?
I don't know. That's not a commuting route I normally take, but...
In your opinion. I'm just throwing that out there. I'm hoping that the state that had promised us that light would be on by now. It's up there. It is up. It just hasn't started flashing or blinking or anything. And I think that would help that back route a lot. I think a lot of people would use it if they knew there was a safer way to come out.
Sure. Yeah, well, I mean, surely on, you know, commuting in the morning time, it's difficult to cut across southbound 235 there. So I would imagine it would help, and it would increase the ability for people to use that exit. I just have assumed it's going to be on fairly soon. Usually, once the signalization gets installed, there's some period of time between installation and implementation, but I know it's been a few weeks at least.
It's been a rather lengthy stay. I think normally the state turns those lights on and lets them flash a couple weeks, if I'm not mistaken, just to give, I'll say, the community a heads up that this light is getting ready to be turned on, and we are waiting with patience in Hollywood.
I'm not sure of the timing on that. When we did the light out at Wildwood Boulevard, it was replacing an existing, so we didn't go through a period like that. But I would imagine sooner rather than later would be better.
It would be better for, you know, anything we can take off of the coming out of your, you know, I mean, you have a lot of folks that come out. I know the light on 4 has helped them immensely.
Right.
If there's just one more way that they can get out and do their thing, I think it would help out with the community. I didn't know if y'all have maybe heard anything from it. I try to feel it out in every direction that I can.
Right. We had not. Most of our conversations with the state have really been limited to the improvements to Route 235 that we have and kind of getting those squared away so that next spring, summer, when the season opens, we can do that work. So we keep the scope of our conversations to that. It keeps it a little simpler.
I'll take care of the other. Anybody else have any questions?
I was just going to say, excuse me, that the stoplight seems to improve the egress from the transfer station as well. That's kind of a
mm-hmm.
added benefit, unintended, or maybe it was intended benefit that.
Right.
It's a good thing.
Out of the transfer station at off Route 4?
Yes.
Yeah.
It actually slows the traffic down so people can come in and come
right.
out. So it's good. I see your next, it seems like your next section is Orchid Park. Is that right? Or not?
Well, Orchid Park is where the models are. Mm-hmm. What we'll likely do is go to section 3, which is on the map, it's called Leland Park. And that's kind of behind Primrose.
Okay.
Based on product, and then probably finish up with Orchid Park.
Okay, I was just trying to see what was next here, and I
right.
guess I misread it.
So presently, Woodland Park, which is kind of at the, call it 6 o'clock position, if you will, we have about 30 remaining single family lots there, and we'll work through those. Those are some of our larger lots on the perimeter. And then we're in the top left corner is Magnolia Park single families.
Okay.
And we're about 25 or 30 lots into, I think it's 107 lots in there. So we're working through that. And then Evergreen Park, which is right above the Evergreen school site, there's townhouses in there. And we've got 2 buildings that are sold. There's like 150 units, give or take. So we'll be in there for a little while. And then section 3 would probably follow that. And then Orchid Park would probably finish it up. And some of that will depend on pacing because there's different products in different sections. So as the pacing demands and requires, we'll develop.
So how are your single family units selling? Are they doing well?
They're doing well. We had a little over 90 sales last year combined. It was shared just about 50-50 for the makeup, which has been the case for the last several years. So the single family product is selling well, and the townhouses are doing well. So we anticipate a pace of probably 80 to 100 a year till we finish out the community.
Thank you.
Any other questions? I do appreciate y'all coming out this evening.
Thank you very much.
Anything we can help y'all with, just please let us know.
All right.
Is there any other business? If no other business, I will accept the motion to adjourn. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Coming out this evening, we're adjourned.